In this video, I am going to review about the basics of particle physics. This video is specially made for the viewers who are just about to begin their study of particle physics or for those who just want a basic introduction of particle physics. It will consist of 5 main parts. In the first part, I will discuss the standard model of particle physics. In the second part, I will discuss the fundamental particles of nature. In the third part, baryons and mesons will be reviewed, and in the second last part, I will review the basic forces of nature in the great detail. And I will conclude it by giving you a short review of interactions in particle physics. Let's start with the standard model of particle physics, which is generally known as the periodic table of particle physics. As the periodic table of chemistry brilliantly grouped all the chemical elements and describe all the chemical reactions on the basis of particle physics, the standard model of particle physics extraordinarily arranged all the fundamental particles of nature and describe all the interactions of particle physics based on this grouping. Standard model of particle physics basically tells us about all the fundamental particles of nature, and it describes the 3 interactions, which are strong interaction, electromagnetic interaction, and weak interaction, corresponding to the 3 forces of strong force, electromagnetic force, and weak force. Slam, Glashow, and Weinberg modeled it independently, and this whole standard model of particle physics can be shown in this figure. It consists of 3 main parts. One is the matter particles, which are fermions because their spin is half. And in this figure, the outermost layer represents these matter particles. The second main class of this standard model is the force carrier, which in this figure is the second layer, in which there are 4 particles, which are W, Z, gamma, and photon. And the third part is the central part, which is the Higgs boson. Higgs boson is responsible for giving the message to all the particles. Now I will discuss all these 3 parts in detail. First one is the matter particles, which are further divided into 2 classes, namely leptons and quarks. Leptons are basically 6 particles, which are electron, muon, tau, and their corresponding neutrinos, that is electron neutrino, muon neutrino, and tau neutrino. These are basically 3 families of leptons. Electron and electron neutrino is the first family, muon neutrino is the second family, and tau neutrino is the third family. They are generally termed as family or generation, that is first generation, second generation, and third generation. The first 3 leptons, which are electron, muon, and tau, are massive particles, and each of them carry a charge of minus E, while their cousins that are their neutrinos are electrically neutral and they are almost massless. Even in standard model, they are considered as exactly massless, while recent experiment shows that they have some tiny amount of masses. So, to sum up, we have 6 leptons, which are electron, muon, tau, and their corresponding neutrinos. Electron, muon, and tau are the massive particles with electric charge, while their corresponding neutrinos are about massless and electrically neutral. The next category is the quarks, which are again 6 and 3 generations, that is up and down are the first, charm and second is the second generation, top and bottom is the third generation. The upward row, which is up quark, charm quark, and top quark, are generally termed as up-type quark, while down quark, strange quark, and bottom quark are generally termed as the down-type quark. They have some properties in common, so we just sum up them in the up class and the down class. The up-type quarks contains electric charge of +2/3 times the charge on electron, while the down-type quarks contains electric charge of -1/3 of E. That is, quarks contain the frictional charge. And along this electric charge, they carry another important charge, which is a color charge. And there are three types of color charge, which are red, green and blue. And due to this color charge, quarks can interact with strong interaction due to this color charge. So to summarize that, we have again six types of quarks, which are again divided into two classes, that is up type and down type. Up type contains a charge of plus 2 over 3, while down type contains a charge of minus 1 over 3. Mass wise, top quark is the heaviest quark with about mass of 175 GeV. Now, baryons is the next term, which is mostly used in particle physics. And by baryons, we mean that the combination of three quarks or three antiquarks. The combination of three quarks or three antiquarks gives us the integral charge. So we have the only three quarks or three antiquarks in the baryons. Examples of baryons are the most popular are the proton, which contains two up quark and a one down quark, and another is the neutron, which contain one up charge, one up quark and two down quark. Third example is the lambda, which contains an up quark, a down quark and a strange quark. These are all the examples of baryons. And for each baryon, we assigned a quantum number of 1, and for each anti-baryon, we assigned a quantum number of minus 1. This quantum number is very important when we will discuss the interactions in particle physics. So, for each baryon, baryon number is 1, and for each anti-baryon, baryon number is minus 1. As baryon is the combination of three quarks or three antiquarks, so according to the quantum rules of spin addition, their spin is either 1 over 2 or 3 over 2. Due to this half integral spin, all the baryons will be fermions. And as I discussed earlier, the electric charge on baryons is integral multiple. That is, either it should be 0 or plus minus 1 or plus minus 2 times the charge on the charge of electron. The next thing which I will review is the mesons. Mesons are made up of one quark and one antiquark. Again, a combination of one quark and one antiquark gives us the integral electric charge. This is the main reason for this combination. And each meson is assigned a baryon number of 0, because it is a combination of one quark and one antiquark. Each quark has a baryon number of plus 1 over 3 and each antiquark has a baryon number of minus 1 over 3. So the overall baryon number of meson will be 0. And again, according to quantum mechanical rules of spin, their spin should be either 0 or 1. And due to this integral of spin, they are termed as boson. And again, electric charge on them is the integral multiple of minus E. Examples of mesons are the pi meson, which contains an up quark and an anti-down quark, while K meson contains an up quark and an anti-strange quark. As mesons are made up of only one quark and one antiquark, while baryons are made up of three quarks or three antiquarks, so mesons are less massive than the baryons. And both mesons and baryons are commonly termed in particle physics as hadrons. Now, talking about the force carriers, we have three basic forces in standard model of particle physics, which are electromagnetic force, weak force and strong force. And each force is carried by some mediating particles, which we termed as force carriers. Electromagnetic force is mediated by photon, which is represented by gamma in particle physics. Weak force have three carriers, which are Z boson or W plus boson and W minus boson. All these three are the carriers of weak force, and the third force, which is strong force, is mediated by gluons. As quarks have color charge, so the gluons also have color charge. And when we discuss about their range, Then electromagnetic force has a long range, while weak and strong forces are the short range forces. Weak force range is just about 10 raised to power minus 18 meter, while the strong force has a range of 10 raised to power minus 14 meter, while the range of electromagnetic force is infinite. Now in the last section, I will review about the basics of interactions in particle physics. As we have three basic forces of nature in the standard model, so it incorporates the three types of interactions corresponding to these three forces. And in this diagram, our decay of W plus boson is shown, and we have a lot of these decays or cross sections or interactions in particle physics, and we can describe them on the basis of certain specific rules, that which interaction is weak, which interaction is strong, or which interaction is electromagnetic. They are distinguished on the basis of certain conservation laws of particle physics, and all these conservation laws and examples of these interactions, that how we can distinguish between a weak interaction, strong interaction, and electromagnetic interaction, is discussed in the next part of this video.